Morpheus from The Matrix once said, "The Matrix is everywhere. It's all around us, even now in this very room." There is a degree of truth in his statement, yet the Matrix we'll actually find is neither a pore of perplexing Japanese codes nor cool computer simulation like the movie shows us. Instead, it's a much more basic and nerdy set of lines, but certainly not less interesting and useful. Let's say you suddenly, out of your own goodwill, want to help your mum compare the prices of chicken nuggets, sausages, and beef jerky sold in 4 nearby grocery stores. You can rearrange the price data into a rectangular array and sandwich it with a pair of square brackets. This is what we call a matrix, or matrices in plural. The data in the array are called entries or elements, and they can appear as number, function, or equation. Let's call this price list matrix as matrix M, for mum. Here, we can see that its elements are presented by rows and columns. Matrix M consists of 3 rows, R1, R2, and R3, and 4 columns, C1, C2, C3, and C4. We can identify the position of an element based on these. For example, element 6 in matrix M is on the first row, R1, and second column, C2, simply stated as M12 equals 6. Hence, we can easily distinguish the elements with the same value but in different positions, such as 3.3 in the matrix, M21 and M23. Additionally, the number of rows and columns specifies the order of a matrix, expressed as M by N. Matrix M is said to be of order 3x4, since it has 3 rows and 4 columns. Is it possible for a matrix to only have 1 row or 1 column? Yes, it's absolutely possible. Matrix with only 1 row is called a row matrix, whereas a column matrix has a single column. A matrix can be equal with another matrix as long as they have the same order and the corresponding elements are equal. Look at the following matrix N. Is it equal to matrix M? First, check their orders. Both are 3x4 matrices, so the first requirement is fulfilled. Second, look at the corresponding element of the matrices. Element M11 should be equal to N11, M12 should have the same value as N12, and so on. In matrix N, some of its elements look different. But if we solve the operations first, we can clearly see that they have equal values. Hence, matrix M and N are equal matrices. We can find the unknown variable of an element based on the matrix equality. If the following matrices C and D are equal, we can obtain the value of A and B in the matrix C by putting them as linear equations. So, A plus 3 in matrix C equals 5 in matrix D, or A plus 3 equals 5, and likewise B minus 2 equals 6. In a matter of seconds, we can tell that the value of A is 2 and B is 8. Matrix is used in various disciplines, such as physics, engineering, economics, and statistics. It has an important role in construction and data encryption as well. Additionally, the digital image processing relies on convolution, which basically uses matrices and products of matrices. The signal in a seismic measurement is also modded in a matrix, where the frequencies become its elements. Now, you've learned about the basics of the matrix. To check your understanding about our discussion so far, can you identify the value of A, B, and C in the following equal matrices E and F? Share your comments below.